So there are multiple application benefits, like the reducing the CPU load, also using a single architecture, so this is easy to use and easy to manage. We also have some features like advanced features, where you can be using our timers for motor control and digital power supply. Here is a recap about the timers that are used inside the STM32G0. So we have multiple timers, as you can see. So we have some advanced timer like the timer 1. We have some general purpose timers, so like timer 2, 3, 14, 15, 16, and 17. And we have some basic ones like the timer 6 and 7. So the one we're going to use today for this lab is the timer 2, and we'll use the timer 1 channel 2 as a PWM output. So this is part of the general purpose timers. So this one, the timer 1, is considered advanced because it has a large number of channels. And also, as you can see, the channel 1, 2, and 3 have complementary outputs. So that can be used for motor control, for example. Here are more features. So as you can see, the timer 1 is really the advanced one. So it has all the different features that are listed here. The timer 2 we're going to be using. So we're going to use the PWM mode like a standard mode. So that's what we're going to use. But as you can see, we support also more than the standard mode. So we have multiple other modes of PWM that are supported. About timer clocking, so timer 1 and 15 can be clocked up to 128 MHz. So this is going to bring us additional resolution, so below 8 nanoseconds. So this could be used, for example, in buck converters, and also so to get a finer resolution and a lower frequency steps. So use case for timer 1 would be because it has three complementary outputs, so we could be using this for synchronous rectification. And timer 15 has only one pair, so we could use that, you know, for the buck and the LLC primary side. Regarding the counting modes, so we support up and down counting modes, but also the center-aligned PWM generation. So the timers also have a built-in support for quadrature encoders. Let me present you a few PWM modes. The first one is the basic one, which is the basic PWM edge or center-aligned. The second one, so here, will be an asymmetric PWM. So asymmetric PWM or phase-shifted PWM. Here are some more PWM modes, so like the combined PWM modes. So this is going to be a combination of different output channels. So like this one, the channel 1, is basically OC1 and OC2 with an OR function. And this one is another mode, so a combined PWM mode with OC1 and OC2. So this is then the output. Here is another combination, so combined mode, so combined three-phase mode, so that is seen here. And now the more advanced PWM modes. So this is, first of all, the variable frequency PWM, so as seen here, and also the cycle-by-cycle control duty cycle. So those are the most advanced PWM modes that are only present on the advanced control timers. Let's do a lab now using the timer. So first of all, we're going to close KIND Microvision 5 that we're using before. So we're going to close it. And then in STM32QMX, we're going to rename our project, you know, from Blinky to PWM. So this is what we're going to do now. First, we're going to close KIND Microvision 5. So I'm exiting the debug mode and closing there. Now we're going to rename our project. So in STM32QMX, so File, Save Project As. And we're going to rename it instead of Blinky, PWM, and save. In STM32CubeMX, now we're going to enable basically the timer 2 channel 1, so which is an alternate function of PA5, which is connected to the LED4, so the green LED that we were blinking before in the previous lab. So we're going to configure, you know, the timer 2 channel 1. To do this, we're going to go, you know, into the pinout configuration tab. First of all, we're going to expand the timers section that is here, click on timer 2, and then select PWM generation CH1 for channel 1. So in STM32 Cubemx, I'm going to the pinout configuration tab here, expanding the timers, selecting or clicking on timer 2, and for channel 1, I'm going to select PWM generation CH1. In this step, we're going to do a remapping of timer 2 channel 1 to PA5. So by default, the tool assigns timer 2 channel 1 to PA0. So what we're going to do is to remap this alternate function from PA0 to PA5. So there is a way to do it. So by default, you will put your cursor on PA0 pin, then press or hold control button and the left click of the mouse on PA0, and then drag and drop, you know, the mouse pointer from PA0 to PF to do the remapping. So we're going to go to PA0, press and hold so the control button and the left click of the mouse. So in blue, you see that gives you the other possibilities for timer 2 channel 1. So we're going to remap it to PA5. And now PA5 has alternate function timer 2 channel 1 as we wanted. For the timer parameters calculation, so we want to have a 1 Hz signal and a duty cycle of 50%. So let's assume that the timer input clock, so TPCLK, is set to 8 MHz. Now, if we set a prescaler of 128, that brings us to a counter clock of 62,500, so which is 8 MHz divided by 128. Now, if we want to get, you know, the 1 Hz, so which is 1 second period, the counter period needs to be 62,500. Why? So because this is going to be like the counter, the clock counter divided by the period. So 62,500 divided by 1. Now for the duty cycle, so we set 50%. So the pulse needs to be set to 31,250, which is half of 62,500. So we're going to start by setting the clock, so the APB timer clock, to 8 MHz. So to do this, we're going to go inside the STM32 Cubemx in the clock configuration tab, and we're going to enter 8 in the HCLK, which is also going to set TPCLK to 8 MHz, as we see here. So we're going to enter 8 MHz, and this is also going to set, you know, 8 MHz to APB timer clock, as we wanted. Okay, we are going to clock configuration, and we're going to enter 8 MHz. This also sets TPCLK to 8 MHz, which is the APB timer clock. So that's the timer input clock. And now we're going to configure timer 2. So to do this, we're going to go first to the pinout and configuration tab in the parameter settings. So here, we're going to click on it, and then we're going to insert the values that we calculated previously. So prescaler, we're going to enter 127. The counter period will be 62,500, and the pulse will be 31,250. In STM32 Cubemx, we're going to go to pinout and configuration tab. And I'm going to make some space. So we're going to configure timer 2. And to do this, so we have different values to input. So 127, so which is the prescaler minus 1, so PSC that we calculated for the counter period. So we said 62,500. And for the pulse, so we scroll down for the pulse, 31,250, which is half of 62,500. Now we can generate the code. So in STM32 Cubemx, we're going to click on generate code. This is going to open this code generation window. And then we're going to click on open project. So this will open KiMacrovision 5. we're going to open main.c, look for the section of the code which is user code begin to, and will end by user code end to. And this section, we're going to add one line of code to start the channel one of the timer two. So we're going to enter this line of code right there. So I'm going to generate the code now. Click on generate code. Click on open project. In Kali Macrovision 5, so I'm going to expand PWM project. Look in the application user, double click on main. Scroll down to, you know, the section that we're talking about. So which is the user code begin to and user code end to. So here I'm going to add one line of code to begin or to get the timer to channel one started. So there is one line of code. So you can find, you know, this code to be added in the description of the video. But otherwise, you know, it's HAL underscore team underscore PWM underscore start. And for parameters, you will give end H team two, comma, team channel one. Now we can build the project. So remember the build option in Kali Macrovision. So there is an icon like this or F7. Once it's built, you will enter the debug session. So start debug session using this icon D. So you can just click on it to enter the debug session. In the debug session, you're going to run the code. So run button. So this is this icon or F5. And then you can see, you know, the LED blinking. So LD4 blinking. So this time at 1 Hz with a 50% duty cycle as we configured it. We can now build the project. So build. Now, so the project built, zero error, zero warning. We can enter the debug session. So make sure that your board is still connected. So to do that, so you can go debug or start stop debug session or control F5 or directly click on D. In the debug session, we are now going to run the project, so run the code with the icon run here or F5. So we click it, the code is running, and now on our board, we can see that LD4 is blinking with 1 Hz and 50% duty cycle as we wanted.